Dear incoming college freshmen, congrats, you got into college and you have hopefully selected a school and you're getting ready to go in the fall. Hey guys, what's up? It's Danielle. I'm sitting here, I'm feeling really inspired and I've been reading a lot of your comments and DMs. A lot of you guys are about to be freshmen in college, which is so exciting, and I was literally just in your position this time last year, which is like crazy. I feel like it was just yesterday, but I wanted to sit down and film a video and I didn't plan anything like legit at all. I was gonna film a video and like write everything down and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna talk. I just want to talk to you guys and maybe motivate you if you're feeling nervous or sad or scared, or if you're excited. I just want to talk to you about a couple things, and I don't know, it's a big time of your life and I just want you to feel good about it. So this time last year, I was getting ready to go to college. I was buying stuff for my dorm. I was FaceTiming my roommate, picking out things, planning my outfits for sorority recruitment. Super excited, you know, spending my last few moments with my friends from high school. You know, it's a really exciting time because everyone, you know, your family members are like saying, hey, like, when do you move? Like, I want to see you before you leave, and like all this stuff. It is so exciting, and I know that you guys are so excited, but I also know a lot of you guys have been struggling. And I'm gonna be honest, I was so excited to, you know, leave home. I was so excited to go to school. I really wasn't feeling any sort of nervousness. I was not like, well, I'm gonna be homesick, until like the day we moved. I remember I like cried leaving my dog in like my room, because my room's like my sanctuary, but I wasn't like so anxious. I didn't get anxious till I actually got to school. I'm here to tell you that your feelings are so valid, and that, as cliche as this sounds, everything is gonna be okay. And it's gonna work out for a reason. For some of you, maybe you're not excited about the school you're about to attend. It wasn't your top choice. Your parents just want you to go to school and, you know, this was your best option. Or, you know, you couldn't afford to go out of state, or you didn't want to go out of state, or you are going out of state and don't want to be there, or whatever it is, it's gonna work out. And if it doesn't, you have other options. I'm a big believer that you are put in places at certain times to have those experiences, or you're supposed to be in relationships or have friendships for certain times because they're defining you as a person. I went through a time, you know, last year, my freshman year at UGA, where I didn't really know who I was for a hot second. I questioned absolutely everything that I was doing. I thought I wasn't, I was like, I shouldn't be here at UGA. I was totally wrong. Like, I don't feel myself. It was so weird. That's normal. And I just wanted to make this video to tell you guys, like, you're gonna go through transitions and this is gonna be like a crazy time, and that's okay. And to just kind of take it all in. I saw this bracelet on my mom's friend the other day and it said embrace change. And that is something that I need to do way more often. I had like the best girl posse ever in high school. I love my best friends. Like, we still talk every day in a group chat. And so going to a whole new school, not knowing anyone, being out of state, you know, it was hard. And I thought I was ready, and I was ready, obviously, but I didn't embrace the change as much as I should have. I kind of kept texting my friends from home and being like, guys, like, no one really here is like you guys. Like, I miss you guys so much. Like, I haven't met anyone that I've meshed with necessarily, other than like my hallmates. Like, my hallmates and I were like besties from day one, thankfully. But I don't know. And it's because I wasn't giving myself or other people a chance. And so my biggest advice to you guys is to go in all of this like totally open book, totally ready to just take on whatever comes at you, because your freshman year of college is such a monumental year of your life. And there are things that I wish I could redo, and that's not possible, but those moments kind of define me and made me learn so much about myself. If someone asks you to hang out or like to go to their dorm, just go do it. Stop whatever you're doing. Stop laying in bed watching Netflix. Go do it. For me, it was, I felt like I needed to be working or doing homework or studying, whatever it was at the time, and I wasn't really opening myself up, and that's one of the biggest regrets I have. My second semester of freshman year was so much fun because I started to just kind of open up more, and I met some of my best friends ever. Like, I literally love so, like, I've made so many amazing friends especially my second semester, just because I really opened up more. I'm gonna make a full-on video where it's like tips for incoming freshmen, but this is more of like a sentimental thing. If you guys ever want to talk, or you're feeling nervous, or you, I don't know, you just want to talk to me about college, like, feel free to message me on Instagram. Like, I've been trying to check my DMs more and respond more. It is hard because there's so many of you, so sometimes I'll like look at your common theme of questions and then I'll answer it in videos. A lot of you guys have been asking, you know, about out of state, and going out of state's definitely harder than I thought, but also super cool. I'm gonna tell you why. Going out of state for school is really exciting and really cool, because when you talk to people, they're like, so where are you from in Georgia? And I'm like, I'm from Tampa, Florida. And they're like, what? That's so cool. You go to the beach like every day. And I'm like, yeah, not really, but you know, let them think that. That's really cool. You're automatically unique. It's really cool for sorority recruitment because they like want out of staters and they think it's really cool. Also going through recruitment, it was weird because people just like assume you're from Georgia, and I didn't know anyone. All my other friends seemed to know someone that knew someone that knew someone, or went to high school with this person, because most of my friends are truly from Georgia. And like, I guess I didn't realize that going into UGA. Not that I really care, like I really don't at all. But it was definitely different because everyone just kind of had some sort of connection and I didn't. So definitely be prepared for that. But for me, what I did is I just tried to like listen and like talk when I could. And if they were talking about high schools, I just tried to remember them so that if they reference it again, I can kind of be like, oh yeah, I remember you said that. Or, you know, because I really like I enjoy learning about different states and school systems and, you know, people. I don't know. I enjoy learning about that stuff. Like I'm starting to learn more cities in Georgia for sure. But overall, I really enjoy it because then, you know, your friends can come visit you in your state and you can kind of show them around. Like, I went to go visit my friend Daly in New Jersey, and it was so cool getting to see her and her family. The other side of that, it's nice when you have friends that are from that state, because for like little breaks where you just have like a Monday off or something, everyone goes home, but then you're kind of like, I'm not gonna fly home just for 3 days. So you can like go stay with them for the weekend. I've done that before. That was really fun. There's so many great things about it, so it's kind of cool. Another thing I want to talk about is college partying. It's definitely a thing, and I knew it was a thing going into it, but I also just, you really can't know what it's like until you truly go to college. I didn't have any bad experiences with like any sort of like, you know, drugs or anything. Like at UGA, no one, like that's not really a thing. Like no one's really in danger necessarily. College partying is a thing, and you can choose whether to involve yourself in it or not. I have not been peer pressured once. I really haven't, and I'm saying this so honestly. People in college just want to have fun. They don't care if you don't want to. If you don't want to, you don't want to, and they're not going to remember if you didn't go out that night or not. I am telling you. I promise you. However, on the other side of that as well, if you like love the idea of it but you're too scared, then definitely, you know, go have some fun. But I think you definitely need to like keep your order straight. Like, I remember my first semester of freshman year, it's like, people are, you know, there's lots of stuff going on just because it's your first semester and your classes are kind of easy, so everyone's just going all out. I couldn't keep up personally, and I really put a lot of pressure on myself. I felt like a crappy person. I was like, why am I not wanting to do this every single night? Like, why am I not, you know, whatever. I thought I was insane, and I kind of put myself down for a while about it. And then I realized it's okay to say no sometimes, but it's good to say yes every now and then. So I just like do something like once or twice a week, which sounds like a lot, but in college it's not a lot. And you know, I eventually found people that like felt the same way I do and like to do things the same amount as I do. And it was just like a really good situation, but that's not gonna come right away. And you just kind of have to like accept that, because that's just how college is. I think friend groups kind of started to form this last semester as a freshman, but I don't, like, I love so many different girls in my pledge class and at my school in general that, like, I don't know, I'm not trying to, like, settle down and, like, you know, like, I love so many different people and hang out with different people, so I'm still kind of exploring. And, you know, it's weird because going from senior year to, like, being a freshman again was weird because I had such a set group of friends and, like, things we did. So then going to freshman year and, like, not knowing anyone or anything was really weird. And if that's gonna be normal, you're gonna feel like that, but just know everyone else is feeling like that, even if they're acting like they're all that in a bag of chips. They're really not, and they're really nervous too, and they don't know what they're doing either. None of us know what we're doing. We're all just trying to get by, get good grades, and have fun. That's what college is, I'm telling you. For me, it was hard though, because I was also trying to like maintain YouTube and like travel for that, and like, that was a whole other thing, but that's my problem, not yours. But yeah, I just kind of wanted to sit down. I just had those thoughts. I hope this video was some sort of help. I really do love you guys, and I care about you guys so much, and I just want you to have as positive as an experience as you guys can, because it is so fun, and you know, college are some of your best years of your life, they say, so you gotta make sure it's worth it. Embrace change and just love life. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know video requests down below. I've been filming a ton of videos, like rapid fire. I'm really into it. I'm back into my routine before I go back to school. So yeah, I love you guys. Thanks for watching. You got this. Comment down below if you're gonna be a freshman and where you're going to school, because that's so exciting. If you're going to UGA, go Dawgs. And I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.